I'll tell you what, I'm really excited about this next one, McMurray versus Nail.
Yeah.
Both of their debuts were early first-round knockouts.
So this is going to be fun.
They're both heavy-handed. They both hit super hard. Like I said, McMurray fought my guy, Hunter Lofton. He was a lot bigger than my guy. My guy probably needs to go to 45. McMurray is huge at 155 pounds. He is an incredible athlete out of an incredible camp.
Are you guys having a good night tonight? Man, I want a big shout out right now to one of our sponsors. Thank you. Without sponsors locally, we can't put on shows locally and bring in local fighters and pro fighters. We have three pro fights and a heavyweight championship bout tonight. Are you ready for a title fight? Thank you, Budweiser. Thank you for your support. Give a big round of applause for one of our sponsors, Budweiser, tonight. And here we go. We're moving on, ladies and gentlemen. We got another MMA fight slated for you. Please welcome Alex Nail.
Alex Nail, like I said, first round knockout in his debut. As a matter of fact, I think it was pretty early. It was a minute 55 seconds. He knocked out Jody Schutt. That was at Attitude MMA back in August 10th. Now he's fighting Caleb McMurray, who knocked out his opponent. I'm going to pull that time up real quick. Knocked out his opponent. The time's not on there. But he, both early, quick first round knockouts.
This should be exciting. I've definitely.
Shout out to Tyler Copeland, who's normally with us on here. He's watching on the live stream. You my boy, Tyler. Caleb McMurray versus Nail.
And here we go. Welcome his opponent to the cage, Caleb McMurray.
I like Nail's shorts. Those Apollo Creed Rocky. Very American flag shorts.
I was gonna say, look, for 55, Nail doesn't look small either.
He's not, but look at Caleb, man. Look how big his frame is. Tall, long. Definitely very warmed up too. Got him a little sweat going. He had a boxing match in Pontotoc not long ago either. And that was also a knockout in the second round. He's got heavy hands.
Okay.
Heavy-handed dude, really athletic, hits hard. I don't see this one going to the distance. Digging the walkout song, got a little vibe going. We're checking the gloves. We got a little tear in the cage free gloves of McMurray. I think they may make him put some different gloves on. This might be a fiasco here at the ringside.
Which, look, fighter safety on both sides is always number one, but.
They're saying he's got to take it off. I think his coaches already took off for a different pair, so now they got to run all the way to the back.
Nothing's going to throw off your mental game.
Yeah. So the commission came over and looked at it. CPAC came and took a look at it. CPAC said no, not going to be able to fight with him. So now Jason is taking the tape off and got to put some different gloves on.
Definitely not something that should be addressed cage side. That should have been figured out beforehand. But
well, you know, it's probably not something him or his coaches were thinking about, was making sure that there's no tear in the gloves.
Probably so. You got to make sure your equipment's on point, though.
Yeah, there's Cody Floyd with a new pair of gloves.
Quick resolution, thankfully.
Yeah, quick. Cody was on it. As soon as they said something, before they even knew if it was going to be a thing or not, Cody took off his back and another pair of gloves. He already knew.
This is not his first rodeo.
Right. He was like, all right, well, let's go, you know. I tell you what, man, you're talking about a guy that has been around a long time and is just an unbelievably good coach and athlete is Cody Floyd, man. He really impressive jiu-jitsu, really impressive striking.
Yeah, man, I got to say, Floyd's competitors always bring their A game. I've gotten to see him compete once, and it was lot of fun.
So me and Cody used to train together some in Tupelo, and I remember he was a 145er, I was a 185er, doing a little bit at 170 at the time, and he used to rack.
All right, we're almost there. We just had a wardrobe malfunction. It was just a switch his glove. It's okay. In the club, we all fam.
What? What does that mean? In the club, we
what?
All fam.
In the club, we're all family. What are you, racist?
What was that off of? I don't remember what this off of. I was doing it with you, though. I said it. I was doing it with you, yeah.
I really want to do the whole thing.
Yeah. I was trying to feed you. I could tell he was trying to set that joke up. I was trying to help him out. It's important if you're going to be funny, you got to have people helping you feed you the joke, you know?
That is valid.
It helps, so I'm going to help him out.
Here we go. Here we go! Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, standing 5'10" tall, weighing in at 168 pounds with a record of 1 win, 0 losses. Fighting out of Memphis, judo and jiu-jitsu, Memphis, Tennessee, Alex Battle Nail. And his opponent fighting out of the red corner, standing 6'1" tall, weighed in at 164 pounds with a record of 1 win, 0 losses. Tupelo Jiu-Jitsu, Tupelo, Mississippi, Caleb Street Beast McMurray.
The size of Caleb.
Now that I'm seeing him.
He's 6'1", and he's got that much muscle mass on him at 100. And he only fights at 155. I think he came at 164 for this one. But he fought my guy at 155 and looked the same.
That's crazy.
As a one fight amateur. Oh man, I'm on the edge of my seat for this one.
Don't blink, y'all. Don't blink.
Oh my gosh, I've got butterflies in my stomach.
Ooh, that
good
was
jab by
very
McMurray.
Nice stiff jab to open us up.
Good low kick by Nail. Tupelo versus Memphis.
And look, these guys are both young. They're fast. Their reflexes are fast. They haven't been hit in the head a lot yet.
But they've hit some people in the head. Good low kick by Nail again. McMurray did a good job stepping away from it, but it still landed.
This speaks very much of the Forrest Griffin-Rampage Jackson fight, where Griffin just wore that front leg out to the point that Jackson could not plant on it.
Now they're banging his own cage side. Banging cage side. Nail looks for a takedown. McMurray strong, wrestles him back up, and circles out. Good job by Caleb
McMurray. There, too. Oh, those low
kicks.
Another
good low kick. That's going to pay off later in the fight. Both these guys are really tough. Big shots by Caleb. I'm telling you, I don't see this one going to a scorecard.
I don't either. I don't. It says a lot about the chin of Nail. Those were not light punches. And look, I'm all the more intrigued. This is not something you see as often at 55. Or catch anything under 170. Even 170, you don't see a ton of big knockouts.
Both these guys can put you to sleep. Good wrestling by Nail. Really good shot. But McMurray, big slam. Now, let me just say, Hunter Lofton had a huge slam.
I remember
slam
that, man. That was such a good takedown, too.
Yeah,
and
McMurray
was
got
like,
up.
Never mind. We're going to stand up.
So let's see what happens here. Good elbow by Nail on top
nicely
there.
Done.
Nail looks good. Both these guys look good. Nail looks really composed. Another big elbow. Another big elbow. Man, Nail is landing some elbows on top here.
And look, with elbows, especially on the ground, you don't have to be as precise.
Spinning elbow landed by McMurray, but Nail is unfazed.
This is crazy.
Big uppercut that barely missed. Another uppercut by McMurray. He's looking for that uppercut. Level changes, level changes. I like what I'm seeing by Nail. He looks really composed. If I was him, I'd be looking to go back to that low kick. Yep, and he does.
Man, if McMurray could set that uppercut up, if that lands, that's going to be the end of the fight. The follow-through he has with the length.
Another good
nice shot
by Nail. And he takes him down again
that
for the second
beautiful.
Time in the round. Good level changes. He's getting under McMurray like he needs to. Really good round. It was a tough round. I got to give it out. Brown and Nail.
Yeah, I mean, two big successful takedowns. There wasn't enough of a discrepancy in the striking for it to have gone the other way,
No, and I don't know how much of a discrepancy there was, really. I mean, it was close.
It was
but
close.
But the takedowns and the elbows on top, to me, sealed it for Nail. Murray's so tough and hit so hard, though.
Man, both of these guys ate a couple of strikes this round that made me flinch.
Yeah, especially 155ers, man.
That's what I'm saying. This is not something we typically see at this weight class.
Cody giving the coaching advice to McMurray. He's got 10 seconds. That's the sign for corners out. Underwood and Floyd making their way out of the cage. Second round. Let's see if McMurray can get something going this round. Nail's looking to get under McMurray's length. He's tall and he's kind of standing up a little tall. It's the level changes that's made the difference so far. But all McMurray needs is one punch and lands a good left hook, barely misses with a right hand. Nice exchange there, and McMurray's back on the wall. I'd like to see McMurray circling a little bit more, not standing in front of him so much. McMurray's such a nice guy. Ooh, big right hand by McMurray. And there's a level change by Nail. They're on the fence, right on the door. Can he take him down again? That's the question. And he puts him on his butt.
Nail's done a really good job of engaging the hips on these takedowns. He hasn't wasted a lot of energy. He's just committed and gone.
Murray comes back up.
Look at Murray's left leg. Holy cow. Ow.
Oh, it's already bruised and welted up.
Yeah.
You can't really see it on the camera, but from where we are, he's already got a huge bruise and weld on his leg. And there he's back on his butt again.
This is going to be a problem if this fight actually does progress to the third round.
And the way it's going, it very well might.
This man, what a good matchup. Again.
McMurray trying to build his base back up, get up the wall. He's got an underhook on that left hand. He's probably going to try to circle to it, and he does. Disengages, they're back on the feet.
I tell you what, I love to see a fight where we have guys swinging for the fences that are also engaging in grappling. That's what MMA is about.
Man, this is crazy. They're landing big shots. McMurray has a little mouse under his right eye. Nail's starting to look a little tired from the wrestling. Flying knee lands to the body of Nail.
Nail does not even look fazed.
Big left uppercut. McMurray's needing a bang. He doesn't need to get too comfortable standing in front of Nail because of that right there.
Man.
Nail's looking at that. Was a really well-timed level change by Nail.
Yes.
Waiting for that big overhand right. He's looking to finish the single leg. And McMurray
nicely
back
done.
On his butt. Back on his butt. Nail flattens him back out. His head's in the wall now. He's in half guard.
This is not where McMurray wants to be. This is exactly where Nail wants to be.
What a fight. These guys are tough, man. Both these guys are going to do big things in this sport if they stick to it.
I was going to say it.
McMurray needs to do a little more on bottom, but with only 4 seconds left in the round, I probably wouldn't waste the energy trying right now.
No.
The round's going to start on its feet for the third. A lot of respect from both these guys. McMurray's just the nicest guy you'll ever meet in your life. If you meet him in person, he's so nice. I met him a week before he fought one of my guys, and he was like, hey, man, you got to – can you tell me anything about him? I'm like, no. But he was just so funny and just, like, friendly and nice after the fights, before the fight,
man,
so friendly and nice.
Guys like that are the guys that go the furthest, because when you have a good, humble attitude like that and you have that work ethic and you're performing like this –
But Nail doing a great job attacking the hips.
Man, his wrestling is impressive.
Yeah.
I'm loving these takedowns.
Well, I think he understands that when you got two guys that hit this hard, anybody can go to sleep at any time. Why give him the opportunity to put you to sleep?
Yeah.
Stand with him long enough, set the takedown up, and put him on his butt where he can't knock you out. Because McMurray can knock you out at any given moment.
All right, last 3 minutes.
Can McMurray do something? He needs a 10-8 round or
a finish. Yeah.
He needs a finish.
And look, a lot of times when these fights go to round three,
overhand.
It's going to be tough. But in this case, it might not.
Nail might be hurt. McMurray knows he's got to get a finish here, and he's landing big shots. There's the level change by Nail, putting McMurray back on the wall. And he does it again.
Man.
That's what he needed to do, and he does it 20 seconds in the first round. McMurray landed big shots.
Yeah, those were some beautiful.
But he got taken down.
Yep.
I'd like to see McMurray not stand directly in front of Nail when he's striking. If he wants to stay on the feet, he's kind of staying in tight, trying to bang, hoping to get the knockout.
Yeah.
And at this point, the knockout is going to come from the pocket. But you can see it in the camera right there, the leg of McMurray.
God.
Those red marks and bruising and welting already coming up.
I'll tell you what.
And that's just from a few kicks. That's not from that many kicks.
Right. He's going to wake up at like 4 in the morning, and that's going to hurt so bad.
Oh, he'll probably limp in the back after the fight. He'll be limping tonight.
Probably so.
He'll be limping tonight.
Nail doing a good job. Head pressure. Staying active.
McMurray needs
no
to come
chance.
Up here.
Yeah, I was going to say, but Nail's making sure that they're not going to get stood up without reason right now.
Murray's just got the underhook, but from this position, he's still directly underneath Nail. He needs to get his hips out to the side.
Yeah, and he's got the space now. He's in a better spot. This is where he needs to start moving and shrimping out and looking for improvement.
He's still got time to do something.
Yeah, I was going to say, a minute 20.
Yeah, he needs to go. He needs to go right here.
As fast as 3 minutes goes, a minute 20 is an eternity.
If he doesn't do something here on bottom to get back to his feet, I don't see how he's going to be able to come back and win this fight. I mean, we're down to a minute. A minute and you're on bottom and being held down. So now not only do you've got to get out of this bad spot, you got to get back somewhere neutral or positive. And then you've got to mount an offense to put Nail away, which we've already seen, not going to be easy. But he's got to do something here.
40 seconds.
I've got this 2 rounds to kneel for Nail. And if McMurray doesn't do something, he's about to lose his fight, I'm afraid.
Yeah, from where he is right now. And Nail scoring points. He's staying busy.
Yeah.
This is a really smart approach.
I promise you it's what I'd be doing.
100%.
I promise it's what I'd do.
I don't want to give any reason to lose the fight.
Or I'd be coaching him to. If I was just coaching in the corner, I'd say, hey, keep doing what you're doing. Stay on top of him. We're down to 5 seconds. Ride it out. Get the win. Yep. Good showing by both athletes. I lied. I said it wouldn't go to a decision. But man,
look,
they put
it did not seem like it was going to, but man, what a fight.
Heck of a show.
Definite fight of the night contender thus far. We still have plenty left, so I'm not going to say anything definitive yet.
Look at McMurray, got a big smile on his face.
I love it.
Shaking his opponent's coach's hand. Nell looked really good in that fight. Looked good on the feet, but did a really good job of getting it where he felt he was going to be the better fighter, which was on the wall, on the ground, and it paid off for him. Lige Mitchell and Cody Floyd in the corner, McMurray. Jared Travis and Zach Underwood in the corner of Nail. Really good fight, a lot of good back and forth action, a lot of big shots landed. Both guys look really composed. This is amateur, so you know you're gonna see these guys again for sure. I definitely see you seeing McMurray again. I definitely hope I see Nail again. I'd like to see him continue and improve. Great athletes, strong, good striking. I definitely wouldn't have stood in front of McMurray either. Not for any length of time. His striking was crisp, good punches, hard punches. The kicks from Nail really looked like they were paying dividends, though.
I'll tell you what, man, I can't wait to see both these guys back. That was a fun fight.
Here we go. Fight fans, ladies and gentlemen, we got to go to the judges' scorecard. Put your hands together. They put it all out there for you. And ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves a draw.
What?
So that means we get to turn around and do this again one day.
Get out of here. How?
I'm here with these two warriors. Real quick, guys. That was a great performance you guys put on. Caleb McMurray, Austin Nail. Are we going to do the rematch? Who am I talking to?
Look, let me gain a little bit of weight first, and then we will.
Yeah, guess what he said, man.
So, March, are we getting that rematch? Because we want to see it. Swanging and banging in there. You took some shots that I don't know most people could take, and you mitigated a lot with some takedowns. It was very back and forth, very competitive. We want to see it. Tupelo, Mississippi, you guys want to see it again? I think they do. So, let's talk to Jamie. Set it up for March. What do you guys think?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
My face is all swollen up right now. I can't.
Give me like 2 hours, I got it.
All right.
That's a fucking dog right there. I mean, I'm so sorry. I did not mean to drop the F-bomb. A little bit of a
McMurray, dog. Oh, I love it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Tupelo, Mississippi. Make some noise for these warriors right here. Caleb McMurray and Austin Nail.
I tell you what, I don't want to take anything away from either fighter, but I don't feel like a draw was accurate. However, I do want to see a rematch.
You know, I'm not a judge. I'm not paid to judge. I'm paid to talk, you know? So
let me just say this. We would also like to see the rematch.
You know, and the rematch may go totally different.
It might.
You talk about
amateur
guys.
Well.